pushing to legalize marijuana. Connecticut Democrats say this is the year they legalize recreational marijuana.
But some members of the party say the current bill does not go far enough. So could we ultimately see another legislative session end without a vote?
Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Mike Savino is joining us live from the Answer Desk with more. And Mike, what did you find out?
Well, there are two bills, one from the governor that would legalize the sale of recreational marijuana, but some Democrats back a second bill that goes more, doing more for people who were hurt by their criminal histories with marijuana. So with these two bills out there, I asked the House Majority Leader which of these bills might get a vote.
If we're going to do it, we're going to do it right, or we're not going to do it at all.
The state legislature is once again debating whether or not to legalize recreational marijuana, but some say we only have one chance to get it right, and they want to see more focus on equity. Governor Ned Lamont agrees that now is the time to legalize pot.
I don't want to surrender this to the underground market, and I don't want to surrender it to outside markets.
A recent Pew Research poll found 60% of people nationwide support recreational and medicinal marijuana, compared with only 8% who oppose any usage. Connecticut is also losing potential tax revenue to surrounding states. New York recently joined Massachusetts in legalizing marijuana, and Rhode Island is also strongly considering it. But a group of Democrats say Lamont's bill doesn't do enough to help people who have been hurt by the prohibition on marijuana.
We really believe that the communities most impacted by the war on drugs should benefit the most.
So what are they looking for? Representative Robin Porter proposed a bill that would completely legalize pot, including growing it at home. People convicted of marijuana-related charges would clear their records and have priority and license to open a marijuana business.
I would urge everybody to hold their fire. Let's take a look at what the overall agenda is.
Lamont's proposal doesn't do those things. It would send some tax revenue back into communities hurt by the war on drugs. But when he addressed reporters recently, he didn't appear willing to accept some of the other demands. House Majority Leader Jason Rojas says he hopes both sides can find a middle ground. Democrats have huge majorities in both chambers. But Rojas is worried competing factions could hold up a controversial vote.
There's other factions within the caucus whose votes we need too.
Now, both of these bills have passed their respective committees, so we'll need to see if either version or some compromise gets a vote before the legislation ends on June 9th. Now, if you have a question or a problem that you'd like us to investigate, use the Channel 3 app and let us know. We're here to cut through the red tape and get you the answers that you need. Live from the Anchor Desk, Mike Savino, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Mike, thank